Jay's Life Out Loud on YouTube. Subscribe, share, and hit that like button. What's going on, y'all? Welcome back to the channel. Yes, you read the title right. Does America hate black people? Had somebody ask me, why would I want to do a video like this? And I told them, because the discussion needs to be had. Because America, for everybody else, is not the same America for black people.
Black people have been fighting for this country, even though they did not get the rights that the flag said. That flag that skipped, I thought the flag meant something. See, I get the flag, you know, the cloth that wave in the wind as the wind blows, but it means something. It's supposed to mean something. Mm-hmm. It's supposed to mean everything for all people. Freedom, liberties. But if the black man doesn't have the same freedoms and liberty as the white, what good is the flag? Mm-hmm. And Drew thinks that, well, I got me, you know, that's what it means to me. I feel a sense of pride, a sense of honor. Everybody doesn't feel like that, Drew, because it hadn't represented them in the exact same way.
Most days, leaving the house, this is how we
feel. No matter your age, when you're black in America, you don't get to be fully American. That freedom we're so fond of talking about as a nation comes with an asterisk when you're black. We're viewed with suspicion. We're never given the benefit of the doubt. Our actions are never presumed innocent. And with that comes a lot of stress. There are moments that sneak up on you, say, sitting in a Starbucks while black, or birding in Central Park while black, or shopping for underwear while black, or Airbnb-ing while black. Then there are those moments when action is needed, but if you've read my writing over the years, you know I never leave home without my driver's license, insurance card, and business card with my husband's cell phone number on it, because you just never know. I'm one vigilante, avowed racist, or homophobe away from calamity. And if I got into an accident on a country road, I'd think long and hard about whether to go to the nearby house for help. Could I be putting myself in more danger by doing so? I can't afford not to think this way. That's what being black in America means. Constantly weighing the pros and cons of countless situations and interactions and hoping you get from point A to point B with as much of your dignity intact, if not your life.
He'll say that we have the same opportunities as you do.
Phil says it would be an absolute disaster if you gave black people money for reparations. Dr. Field decided to opine on reparations. He's factually incorrect on a few things. Number one, Doc, you owe your entire damn career to a black woman named Oprah. You need to be careful here.
He'll say that we have the same opportunities as you do.
At the very same time that America refused to give the Negro any land, through an act of Congress, our government was giving away millions of acres of land in the West and the Midwest, which meant that it was willing to undergird its white peasants from Europe with an economic floor. But not only did they give the land, they built land-grant colleges with government money to teach them how to farm. Not only that, they provided county agents to further their expertise in farming. Not only that, they provided low interest rates in order that they could mechanize their farms. Not only that, today many of these people are receiving millions of dollars in federal subsidies not to farm, and they are the very people telling the black man that he ought to lift himself by his own bootstraps.
So you say that slavery is over. That's what you tell us. And that we should move on, and there's plenty of opportunities here in America. But without fixing the things that came out of slavery, you know what? I'm gonna let somebody else, what a doctor in front of their name, tell you.
Policies of slavery and Jim Crowism. We are still bearing the burdens and the scars. They were never corrected. That's one of the failings of our leadership in this country. They had the nerve, the audacity to let black folks suffer for 460 years. And at the end of the civil rights movement, rather than going back and saying, let's find out what has happened to black folk for 460 years, Have they been psychologically, emotionally, politically, educationally damaged? Nobody spent 1 minute of time trying to figure out what had happened to black folk over all that period of time. So in the course of the civil rights movement, at the end of it, they say, well, let's pretend that nothing has happened to them, that they were not injured, they were not hurt. And now let's go seek integration and pretend that we're all equal. Now that was grossly unfair, because by that point in time, in about the 1966 period, whites had become economic giants in America. They owned and controlled everything at that point in time. Black folk didn't own anything. Whites controlled almost 100% of all the wealth, the income, the privileges, the businesses, the resources, and all levels of government. And they allowed us then to use integration to walk from our communities, from our ghettos, over in their communities, totally disarmed, not understanding anything, blind, naked, and then saying that you can go and compete. Compete with what?
And you would ask me, why would I say, does America hate black people? Now, you watch these previous videos, but I want to show you that no matter where black people are or what they're doing, America will show you that they don't like you. Here's one thing that you can't do while black: supporting your friend running a marathon.
Well, continuing with the fuck the police trend today, this story comes out of my state, the wonderful blue, progressive and tolerant Massachusetts. Black Running Club had set up along the Boston Marathon to cheer and support runners or surrounded by the police. Only this Black Running Club was surrounded by the police.
I think I'm trying to do here. But, all around here, and the helicopter right behind us. Why are we surrounded by
Didn't do that to anybody else. Nope. Just the Black Running Club.
You can't be in the hotel lobby of your hotel room as a black person in America.
She spit on me and told me I don't belong here. And it's my birthday today. Happy birthday to me.
I'm not allowed to eat here.
Get out of here.
Ma'am. She's a guest.
I don't care.
You can't bring her out of here.
You can't go to college and be a dorm monitor while black in America.
Could you stop? No. Thank you. I'm getting off. Are you
all right? I did not get paid enough for this.
Exactly.
You just kissed your entire future away, babe.
Multiple times, she's hit me twice. She's hit me in the stomach.
Black families moving into the Hunters Brook subdivision of Indian Head, Charles County, watched their stately homes burn. Five white men, some volunteer firefighters, were convicted of arson. One of the men who pled guilty in federal court said they targeted the homes because the neighborhood was going black. That part was true. In 2000, black people accounted for 26.1% of Charles County's population, a 75% increase from 1990. Most of its new residents were coming from Prince George's County, according to the U.S. Census. A major change for this mostly white.
Johnny Mae Austin was the black tester, and Cindy Perry was the white tester. And they met with Anne-Marie Quealy Bichon at Signature Premier Properties office in Cold Spring Harbor. They asked for the same thing. As often happens, the agent discussed getting pre-qualified or pre-approved for a mortgage by a bank, showing how much a buyer can spend on a house.
You're pre-qualified, I guess.
My husband's working with somebody in a bank.
We've done some preliminary talks, you know, about getting pre-approved.
Neither had been pre-approved or pre-qualified. Here's what the agent told the black tester.
So I really need that. I won't take out anyone unless you have a pre-qualification letter. So I need to know
that means
I can't pre-qualify for a mortgage.
Oh, so that means I can't go out to see anything.
I won't do it. You can try another person, but I don't have the time.
And without pre-approval, here's what the agent told the white tester.
What is your availability? When can you start looking at houses?
I would say not this coming week.
Cindy received 79 listings from this agent. Johnny May couldn't get any listings. Mm-hmm. And Cindy, the white tester, received 2 home tours. They had the same finances, the same budget, and they made the same request in the same area. But one was white, the other was black. The agent treated them differently. Queely Bichon did not respond to a letter, calls, and emails. Her agency, Signature Premier Properties, co-owner and 2 branch managers viewed the recordings and declined to comment.
It's on, baby. Well, I cannot get rid of these old slots. I got knots in my mind.
Stay right here. I gonna mess y'all up with
it. You probably will, bro. I don't know why people do that shit. I have no idea why.
What?
Y'all see somebody catching fish. And go right there. Yeah, my ass, bro. I don't know why the fuck people do that dumb ass shit. Instead of, you got a hole late in a boat, and you go pull right here. Talking about, is it all right? Hell no, it ain't all right.
Kayak, bro. I know what you're talking about.
Well, get a brand new kayak.
Oh,
hey, bro, you got a smart ass mouth. You better watch who you're talking to. You better watch who the fuck you're talking to. Third time today.
Oh. Hey.
Can monkey come play?
Who?
Monkey?
Who is monkey?
Your son.
That's not his name. Why would you call him Monkey?
We just call him that.
I don't think that's a nice name, though. Did he say it was okay to call him Monkey?
I don't know. I just got it from my friends.
Would you want somebody to call you an animal name? Okay. Well, Jaden is his name, and he's not coming out to play with you guys today, and Cadence is. She's asleep. All right?
Okay.
Accused officers Kevin Piner and Brian Gilmore and Corporal Jesse Moore of violating standards of conduct and using inappropriate slurs, including the N-word. Investigators say that Piner described killing black people in a new civil war, saying, quote, wipe them off the lead map.
Williams is the first black police chief for the Wilmington, North Carolina Police Department. It was his first day on the job. And do you know what the first thing was that he did on his first day? He fired these officers. Chief, one of the officers wanted to resign, but you said, no, I'm going to fire you.
We're tired of officers being involved in misconduct and walking away quietly. I wanted to fire them to make sure that their chances of being rehired again were minimized. These individuals do not deserve to be in law enforcement.
Video audit of Officer Piner's patrol car. He is heard telling Corporal Moore that he is, quote, ready for a civil war and plan to buy an assault rifle to, quote, start slaughtering them in words. During a phone call, Moore refers to a woman who he claims was resisting arrest as the N-word multiple times. And he says, she needed a bullet in her head. According to the investigators, each officer admitted it was their voice on the video, but blamed their comments on the stress of the job, arising from the stress of today's climate.
to anything that makes it nothing but a kind of neat, tidy, white picket fence, morning in America kind of view of things. This is a complicated world, and race is in everything we touch, not because I'm looking for it, but because we were founded on the idea that all men were created equal. The guy who wrote that owned hundreds of human beings and didn't see the contradiction or the hypocrisy. And so our whole story is based in a discussion in race, along with the meaning of freedom. And that's complicated, too, because freedom, you know, what I want, personal freedom, comes into conflict with what we need, a kind of collective freedom. So there is that great struggle. Why are you so frightened of telling your children about the struggles? We go to gym class at 6 years old and have somebody yelling at us that we're not doing something right, but somehow you can't move over to history and find out that something in the past wasn't quite right. This doesn't make any sense. It's a disconnect. And what its attempt is to narrow, as I'm saying, our view of ourselves into one narrow thing. As our country becomes more diverse, which is wonderful, and more complicated, and lots of manifestations, that's who we are. That's been our strength from the very beginning.
I'm really getting tired of the work that is done to protect white feelings. And this isn't personal against white people, it's personal against systemic racism. And I'm sick of the fact that I even have to say that, right? I'm sick of the fact that when I talk about white privilege or systemic racism, white people take it as I'm talking directly to them. And by now, they should have done the work to not even be there. If you're taking it personally, then it might be personal for you, and you need to look into why that is. How do we talk about diversity, equity, and inclusion? How do we get better in this world? How do we dismantle systemic racism if every time you talk about something, you know, you have some white people coming and reporting your video for being racist when it's not? As I keep saying, talking about race, it's not racism, not at all. And then because evidently the people who evaluate the ones who are putting in these ridiculous claims are just as ignorant, are misinformed, are uninformed as the reporters, they take it down. It's just so incredibly frustrating. I don't think anything in my career has made me just want to holler. Well, that's a lie. A lot of things have. But this is definitely another thing that whether it be on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, simply talking about racism can get you silenced. And where are we going to go with that? How is that ever going to help anybody? Like, if the only thing we do is protect white feelings, if that is the priority, this country is going to go nowhere. The fragility has got to stop running everything.
I know, and you guys are not going to be able to disagree with this, if you tell the truth, you're going to ruffle feathers. If you tell the truth, you'll lose your job. If you tell the truth, people think you're a bad guy. The truth is the problem that people have in society.